By now, I hope that you have a basic understanding about how to use Scratch. If not, please go back to our previous lesson on Introduction to Scratch. We are now going to develop the fire safety game that we designed in Unit 3. Alright, let's get started. First, we can give a name to our game. Now we can add a backdrop. Perhaps inside the house. I guess you could remember from the design of level 1, we expect the players to select the most important things to take during a fire evacuation. So let's add these items to the house. We can add items as sprites because we can click on them. I'll show you how to add sprites, then you can add as much as you like. Alright, now the user interface looks good. Let's start coding our game. I want the character to welcome the players and give instructions. Click the character, drag the blocks to get a username, and put a message to welcome the player. Let's see whether it's working. Now we can add functionality to other sprites. If the dog, cat, or baby is clicked, then we can display a message saying correct. Otherwise, it's a wrong guess. Okay, we can check whether the game is working properly. The game will keep playing without any result or score. Let's add this as a game element. Now we need to decide how to calculate the results. We need to store whether the player clicks a correct item or incorrect item and calculate how many incorrect or correct items are clicked. In order to store this information, we use variables. We can keep two variables, one to count the correct clicks and the other to count the incorrect clicks. Now let's add that functionality to the sprites. First, we need to declare our variables. And within each sprite, we can increment the corresponding variable. Now we want to know whether the correct variable has reached its maximum. Let's say 3. We can use a condition to do this. For example, if the correct variable reaches 3, we can congratulate the player. We can put a new backdrop or sprite with a message congratulating the player. For the incorrect sprites, we can do the same by incrementing the incorrect variable until 3 and then display a message. Let's see how the game works. Now we can add some cool features to the game to make it live. What about changing the color of the balloon? We can do it repeatedly until the game finishes. Let's repeat this action by using a repetition block. Okay, we're all done. Feel free to remix the Caesar game and add more functionalities to it or some new levels.